Good morning everyone and welcome back to this series of video on Biomod 2. Today we will see how to model several species distribution within Biomod 2. Before to start, I would like to highlight that most of you, what you will see today is extracted from Habitat Suitability and Distribution Models book, which is a really good source of information if you want to go further with species distribution modeling and in particular with Biomod 2. To be able to follow what I will say today, you will first have to watch the video of Introduction to Biomod 2 by Wilfried Thuillier and to complete the tutorial on single species modeling. If you are familiar with R and you have some basics of GIS and raster package, that's also a good thing for you. So today we will model a couple of species from the Larus family. We will just look at European scale and work with annual mean temperature, annual precipitation and mean temperature of the wettest quarter to explain the distribution of this species. Just to give you an overview of what we will do today, we will start by getting the data and selecting the workspace, then read the data within R. The next step, which is maybe the most important, is to develop a wrapper that contains all the basic steps of a single species modeling. That's why you have to watch the first video of this series. Then we will apply this wrapper to all the species of our family, and at the very end of this tutorial we will produce an alpha diversity map of the Larus. Let's start by getting the data. As in the previous tutorial, all the data are stored on GitHub on Biomod Hub repository. In Biomod 2 tutorial material you will find Biomod video multi-species modeling, so just click here and download the file and extract it on your computer. You should have a very similar structure than in the previous tutorial, with data where you will find the species data and the world climate predictor we will use, and in the script directory you can find the script I will run today. As always, the first thing we want to do is to set up the directory. I have just opened my script in RStudio. The first thing I want to do is to set up the working directory that I want to work in WorkDir. Then you have to load all the packages that are required for this tutorial, but that should not be a trouble since you have completed the single species modeling and that's exactly the same packages. If no error appears, then we can go to the next step, which is reading the data. Let's read our Larus occurrences data. So with the head function we can see that we have a three column data frame. The first one is the species name, the second and the third one are respectively the longitude and the latitude of the species occurrences. With table function we can have an idea of how many species occurrences we have per species. So we can see that most of our species have 500 occurrences, but we have two that have few occurrences points. Let's now construct a vector of species unique names. It contains the name of all the species we want to model afterward. Then we can load the environmental variable, that is to say Bio1, Bio12 and Bio8 for the current and in 2050 and 2070. Let's now implement the single species modeling wrapper. This wrapper or this function will apply to every single species all the Biomod 2 workflow. That is to say formatting, defining model option, running individual and some models, and then do the projection. In this example, our wrapper is called Biomod 2 wrapper and takes a species name as the input. Let's investigate rapidly what's going on in this wrapper. So the first step is to extract from the full dataset only the occurrences of our species of interest. Then we will use Biomod formatting data function. Because we are working with presence only data, we have to define some pseudo absences. Here, two randomly generated sets of pseudo absences with 1000 pseudo absences in each set. This bit of the code will create for every single species a PDF showing how pseudo absences have been selected. That's the printed output of the SP format object. Then we define the option, so all the basics option or the default option for this example. The following line are here to run the individual models, so here a GLM, FDA and Random Forest with two cross-validation with 70% of the data to calibrate the models. We will also use the TSS and ROC evaluation and compute three times the variable importances. I have added also a couple of lines to produce some model score graph for every single individual species, so according to the models, to the dataset or the CV run selected, and they are all wrapped up in the model score PDF. We will then run our ensemble models. In this case, we will keep only individual models having a TSS score upper to 0.4, and we will compute only the probability weighted mean model. The last part is to produce the projections of the individual and the ensemble models. As you can see here, we will loop over all the scenario which has the current, the 2050 and the 2070 conditions. At the very end, we just output a sentence saying this species modeling have been completed. If I have been too fast for you, I really encourage you to watch again the single species modeling from this series of video where every single step is better explained. So let's just load this function within R, just executing it. Up, you go from the beginning here, Control Enter, and that's down. Now the wrapper have been defined, we can just apply it to all the species in our list. This is a very time-consuming and computing-consuming step. So if you want to save some time, maybe that's a good idea to run this example only on a subset of species, for instance. You can select only the three first species like that. This implies that your final maps will be based on really few species, but for pedagogical point of view, that's not really meta. That being said, I will use myself the full list of species so I can come on that. So you can choose to do that with a simple for loop, but for those that have good computing facility, and that's what I will show you today, you can also run it in parallel. I will launch the function in parallel with the Snowfall package. The first thing I have to do is to load the package. Like that. Then I have to initial the cluster. So I have to say how many CPU I want to use. Here, 5 for instance. Then this function is to say all what have been loaded in my current environment should be exported to the cluster. Then we have to load the required library. So here, Biomod2. And then you can launch your parallel loop with SFLApply. So I apply to all the species I want to model my wrapper. So if I have a look to my computer performance, I can see that almost full here. This is maybe now the best part of the video since you have a while in front of you. So just grab a coffee or a tea and go to breathe some fresh air. And let's come back in, let's say, 10 or 15 minutes, depending on your computer performances. Welcome back. It seems that all our species have been computed smoothly. If it is true, some file will have been produced on your computer. So let's have a look to the workdir directory. And here we see that for every single species, we have a separate directory. Each of these directories contains several files. For instance, you can find the PDF we have been producing. In particular, you have one single folder for each projection scenario. In each directory, you should have a projection.out and ensemble.projection.out files. This file contains your model projections, and we will use them to produce our alpha diversity map. Last step before we're done is to produce our alpha diversity map. We will have to load our model projection in the works. For instance, here, for every single species, I define the path to the current projection for the weighted mean algorithm in a binary format. We want to use the binary version of this projection because we want to produce an alpha diversity map which is based on presence and absences of the species. So let's do that. So I will start by loading the projection for the first species and then use a for loop to add all the other species projection with this for loop. I can use exactly the same approach for the 2050 and 2070 condition. So let's just run this bit of code. So we have produced three alpha diversity maps for the current 2050 and 2070. And we can just display them with level plot function from the raster vis package. You should get this lovely alpha diversity map. We can see that most of our species are located in the north, and that these species will move upper north and upper north in the future. Well done, guys, we are done. So what's coming next? There will be a video on biomode 2 specificity to go deeper into biomode 2 by Maya Gegin, and another one on Chiding biomode, which is using biomode, basically doing what we did today, but with a graphical interface. I hope you enjoy. Bye.